Graduation from high school is an important milestone in the lives of students and their families. The graduation ceremony is a dignified occasion and a time of celebration. Appropriate behavior will allow everyone in attendance to recognize the achievement of each graduate. Courteous and considerate behavior will make this a ceremony that we'll treasure as a memorable event. A photographer has been contracted to capture this graduation. A photo of your son or your daughter receiving his or her diploma will be taken. Therefore, we ask that everyone please remain seated throughout the ceremony. As we begin the processional, please stand and remain standing until all the graduates have been seated. At the conclusion of the ceremony, everyone must exit the stadium. Graduates will not be allowed to gather with their family in the stands. We ask that you please keep your face mask on from now until you arrive back at your vehicle.
Gentlemen, please remove your hats for our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
That was sung by Dakota Ridge alumni, Allie Klassen. So please be seated. We made it, finally, huh? All right, here we go. So good evening. On behalf of the entire staff at Dakota Ridge High School, we would like to welcome the parents, guardians, families, friends, and honored guests to our commencement exercise for the class of 2020. We are honored to have you here with us today to help us celebrate the accomplishments of this class. On this memorable day, will you please take a moment with me to remember those who are not with us? Thank you. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce our honored guests. Platform guests, please stand and remain standing until all names have been read. Please hold your applause until all guests have been introduced. Board of Education member, Mr. Ron Mitchell. Community Superintendent, Mr. Scott Allensworth. Community Superintendent, Mr. Lee Cooper. Assistant Principals, Mr. Mike Doherty, Mr. Matt Heckel, Mrs. Kim Keller, and Mrs. Brenda Lucas. Principal, some of these principals may not be here, but Principal of Blue Heron Elementary, Ms. Ann Larkin, Colorado Elementary, Ms. Karen Pratt, Mount Carbon Elementary, Ms. Tracy Jett, Powderhorn Elementary, Mr. Bob Weddle, Westridge Elementary, Mr. Jonathan Stein, Summit Ridge Middle School, Ms. Andrea Schultz, our faculty speaker, Mr. Andrew Geisen, our faculty heralds, Mr. Jason Casanova and Mr. Nick Cummings, our school nurse, Ms. Amy Doolittle, our counselors, Ms. Kirsten Link, Mr. Brian Plouts, Ms. Julie Plouts, Mr. Niall Smith, and not here with us today, Ms. Karina Wilson, special parent, Ms. Yolanda Griego. Ladies and gentlemen, our honored guests. Last year, we added a new tradition to our graduation ceremony. This tradition involves our student government selecting a staff member from each of our feeder schools who've made a substantial positive impact on them during their life at school. Honor staff members, would you please stand and remain standing until all names have been read? Please, again, hold your applause until all honor staff members have been introduced. Honor staff member, Blue Heron Elementary, Mr. Andrew Schilling. Honor staff member, Colorado Elementary, Mr. Dustin Reynolds. not with us today, but from Mount Carbon Elementary, Miss Debbie Spicer. Honor staff member from Powderhorn Elementary, Mr. Michael Freeman. Honor staff member from Westridge Elementary, not with us tonight, but Miss Heather Ortiz. Honor staff member from Summit Ridge Middle School, Mr. James Scott. Ladies and gentlemen, our honor staff members. Families, relatives, on behalf of the outstanding faculty and staff of Dakota Ridge High School, we thank you. Thank you for your trust in us. Thank you for your involvement in your students' lives, and thank you for your support you have shown during the past 4 years, 4+ years. Families, friends, and relatives of graduates, would you please, at this point, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Graduates, as you think back over your years at Dakota Ridge High School, I hope that you will reflect on the support you have received from your parents, guardians, relatives, friends, and teachers, and that you will take this opportunity to thank them for their help. We are here today to celebrate and honor your academic accomplishments, but I also hope that you will reflect on the opportunities that you were given to become better people, to make a difference, and to leave a legacy. There are so many people that have helped our students be successful throughout the years. I would especially like to honor our teachers, paraprofessionals, secretaries, campus supervisors for all of their hard work and dedication to our students, parents, and community. Please stand at this point and be recognized. At this point, I would like to take a moment to recognize some special graduates of the class of 2020. Please note in the graduation program, these students' names are specially marked. Students who have earned straight A's throughout their high school career are noted as Eagle Scholars in your program. At this time, I would like to ask all students who have earned straight A's throughout their high school career to stand and be recognized. Thank you. Several students have maintained a cumulative weighted 4.0 or higher grade point average throughout their 4 years at Dakota Ridge. This academic achievement is to be commended and recognized. At this time, I would like to ask all students who have a cumulative weighted 4.0 grade point average or higher and are wearing a gold cord to stand and be recognized. International baccalaureate diploma candidates are students who have committed themselves to a rigorous 2-year program that consists of a challenging and comprehensive curriculum covering 6 areas of study. Along with their course requirements, all diploma candidates complete the core elements of the IB, which includes the extended essay, theory of knowledge, and an 18-month community service project. IB diploma candidates are wearing a light blue cord, and 100% of our diploma candidates this year achieved their diploma. Please stand and be recognized. To become a member of our Dakota Ridge High School National Honor Society, students must have a cumulative grade point average of 3.8 or higher and have accounted for 20 hours of community service each semester during membership. These students are wearing white cords. At this time, I would ask all National Honor Society members to please stand and be recognized. Those students wearing civil cords represent graduates who have a cumulative weighted grade point average of 3.8 to 3.99. Would those students please stand and be recognized? We have students wearing colored cords that signify special education achievement. Those students wearing purple, cardinal, or rainbow colored cords representing Warren Tech National Honor Society, 4-year student government members, National Arts Society, and or our Seal of Biliteracy candidates, please stand now and be recognized. This year, on behalf of the entire Jeffco Public Schools community, all graduates were provided a purple cord to wear at graduation. This cord represents resilience and the ability to succeed in spite of challenges. Despite the impact of COVID-19 and its unexpected ending to your Dakota experience, please remember that this moment does not replace all the positive ones you've had as a student. You will be stronger because of this experience. Next, all students receiving All-State, All-Conference, or National Honors in athletics or activities, please stand and be recognized. The next group of students who are to be recognized are those who have received college scholarships for their academic and/or athletic achievements. This year's senior class has been offered scholarship funds totaling over $2.5 million. Would these scholarship recipients please stand and be recognized? All students going into a military academy or enlisting in the armed forces, as well as any family members in the audience who have been or are currently active armed forces member, and many of them could not be with us at graduation today because they've already had to report. Would you please stand and be recognized? Those that are here. At our inaugural commencement exercise, we introduced several traditions that remain a part of our graduation ceremony. One of these traditions includes the robing of our student body and senior class president and vice president. Normally, our assistant principals would help assist with the robing of our student leaders, but due to social distancing, the protocols this year, we will just have them stand up here to the right of me and be recognized. The four of you please come forward, president and vice president, Taylor LaGault and Joe Carlson. And senior class president and vice president, Nolan Miller and McKenna Dickey. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, to give our welcome to the senior class, Nolan Miller and McKenna Dickey, our senior class president and vice president.
Hello, everybody. We are glad to have you here.
We would like to welcome you to our 2020 graduation.
We want to thank everybody that has brought us here, from our very first elementary school teachers to all the staff at Dakota Ridge.
We have been working towards this day for the past 13 years, and it's finally here. Congratulations.
To the teachers, parents, friends, and everybody who has helped support the class of 2020 in their academic career thus far, thank you.
You've given us the tools we need to succeed, and I can confidently say that we would not have been able to make it here without all of you.
Students, we have made it a long way since freshman year.
We have accomplished so much and have left so many lasting legacies.
We've been through a heck of a lot together, from the Shrek juice on the stairs freshman year to our ongoing global pandemic.
While these events may have occurred during our high school career, they are hardly what define us.
We are so much more, and that deserves to be recognized.
Our fervent spirit and our loyalty to our school has been something that has defined our class the most.
The class of 2020 has changed the way we celebrate school spirit, and we all know that our heart and our souls have been poured into Dakota Ridge.
We truly embody what it means to love our school and support it in every way.
From games to concerts to theater performances, we were there, ready to cheer on our fellow Eagles.
I know I speak for all of us when I say we are sad to be leaving Dakota.
But we will always be Eagles at heart, and Dakota will hold a special place in all of our lives.
We have called Dakota Ridge home for the past 4 years, but now we're on to bigger and better things.
We wish you the best and cannot wait to see the lives that we build for ourselves. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to introduce our salutatorians that are seated on the stage. Our salutatorians are wearing a white honor sash and will be presented with a gold medallion. Would our three salutatorians please approach the front table? I would like to invite our principal, Dr. Jim Jelinek, to assist in the presentation of the medallions. Our salutatorians are Marco Cordero. Lissa Sheehan. And Brianna Bender. Ladies and gentlemen, our salutatorians for the class of 2020. It is now my honor at this time to introduce our valedictorians. Our valedictorians are wearing a white honor sash and will be presented with a gold medallion. Would our two valedictorians please approach the front table? Our valedictorians are Philip Casey Ryan Bowie.
Velcro on the back here.
Ladies and gentlemen, your valedictorians for the class of 2020 will now speak.
As Kenlyn Blackwell once said, all I want to tell you is that school's not important. Be whatever you want to be. If you want to be a dog, roof, you know?
As we step into the next chapter of our lives, we reflect on the memories we've made here at Dakota Ridge High School. And in this process, we have begun to see that this quote rings more and more true. Now, our schooling is important, of course, but we have grown together, formed friendships, and even more importantly, begun to discover who we are in this world.
The future means something different for all of us. But that's what gives us the sense of purpose we have as a community. It is clear to see that the Dakota Ridge community has grown and shifted over these 4 years, but change isn't something to fear, it's something to adapt to. And our class has done that time and time again. Anyone here can attest how admirable this resilience is.
We want to thank the faculty of Dakota Ridge High School for helping to foster the desire for education we all share. From the custodians to the administrators to the teachers, thank you for leaving your legacy on the class of 2020. Thank you to all the families in supporting our class as we are able to learn and grow because of you.
The changes in our class are more noticeable today than they have ever been, but they won't stop here. Philip and I could stand here and tell you that you can be whatever you want to be or that your community is always here to support you. But remember that you have the potential to help others in incredible ways. In light of recent events, we would like to offer our support and advocacy for the Black Lives Matter movement and the families impacted by inequality. The class of 2020 will be able to leave their legacy just as the Dakota Ridge community has left on us, making the world a better place in this process.
Thank you.
This year, one student has been selected to speak on behalf of the class of 2020. We will now hear from Madeline Nightingale Lujan.
Remember 5 years ago when the picture of the dress went viral? We were in middle school then. You'd be sitting in a middle school classroom, and then all of a sudden, some kid shows you a picture of a dress and asks, "What colors do you see?" So you say, "White and gold." And they're like, "No, it's black and blue." Then in seconds, the class is divided in half and kids are arguing and placing bets. While the dress might have caused a lot of commotion, it revealed the differences in human perception of color. The dress also helped teach us about perspective. As a middle schooler, we didn't really think about, oh, we see different colors because there's a difference in the superposition of our neural signals. No. We thought, you're weird and I'm not. Perspective. Realizing that your classmate sees things differently because they have a different brain or because they have different things happening in their life is called putting things in perspective. Putting things in perspective would be choosing to understand why the other person sees black and blue, even though you only see white and gold. So, when would this be important? Well, what if a massive worldwide pandemic occurred, disrupted a lot of people's lives, and canceled a ton of stuff, like the end of senior year and potentially the beginning of college? Maybe then. I was sitting in my English class when the school announced that all spring sports and activities would be canceled through April. My first thought was, dang, I just bought a really expensive, non-refundable prom dress. Where will I ever get to wear this thing? At that time, Corona didn't seem like that big of a deal. I didn't honestly believe March 13th was going to be my last day of high school. First it was closed for 1 week, then it was three. Then we learned we would finish our senior year virtually. For a long time, I was really angry that everything I had looked forward to for all of high school, prom, graduation, senior prank week, was being taken from me. And everyone in my house was aware of my losses, especially after my several very loud mental breakdowns. My mom even told me if I kept it up, she was going to put me out on the sidewalk. Then it dawned on me. I wasn't the only one who had lost these things. All of us had. Eventually, I realized the only thing that had taken my senior year was my negative perspective. It's sad that we didn't get to go to prom or have prank week. But compared to the bigger impacts of Corona, these are pretty minor inconveniences. Millions of people are out of work. Millions of others are putting their health and their family's health at risk because they need to earn a living. And they don't have the kind of job you can do with an internet connection and a laptop. Most importantly, about 160,000 people have lost their lives here in the United States. We're learning how fragile life is, and we're learning what bravery is in a way that previous graduating classes didn't get to. We used to think bravery was being a soldier, or a fireman, or in search and rescue. Now we see bravery as being a doctor, nurse, or janitor at a hospital, risking their lives to save people with COVID-19. Bravery is being a grocery store worker, keeping food on the shelves. And bravery is being a meat packer, a truck driver, or a teacher. We don't get to choose the obstacles life throws at us. We do get to choose how we respond. We can choose to be angry about losing the last milestones of high school, or we can choose to grow. This choice is ours. Lasts don't have to be endings. They can be doors to new beginnings. So what choices will we make? How will we better our future? The same way we made our high school years so great. We'll do it together. We cheered the loudest at games together. We had the rowdiest homecoming together. We finished high school in the midst of the biggest public health crisis in a century together. Today we will walk across this stage together, staying 6 feet apart, of course. To say the class of 2020 left their legacy at Dakota Ridge is an understatement, but to say our legacy is complete is incorrect. Our true legacy will be seen in the years to come and the choices we make as the first graduating class after the coronavirus pandemic. So I ask again, what choices will we make? For my part, I choose to try and understand and accept why others see black and blue, even though I can only see white and gold. Thank you. All Eagles, all family.
Could our soloist, Jordan Reinhard, please approach the stage? Quick. In honor of the class of 2020, we'll now present Jordan Reinhard's performing The Best Day by Taylor Swift.
change in the flow. I know you're not scared of anything at all. Don't know if Snow White's house is near or far away, but I know I had the best day with you today.
Thanks, Jordan. Nice job. One of the traditions you'll see at our graduation commencement is that of our faculty address. This year, the class has selected Mr. Andrew Geisen to give that address. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Andrew Geisen.
What's good, class of 2020? I have missed you guys so very much. It is good to see you again one last time. Congratulations to the class of 2020. It is such an honor to be up here to give the faculty address. Thank you. This means so much to me as this is my first freshman to senior graduating class. I started teaching only 4 years ago, and you are my first. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's hard to believe that it was only 11 years ago that I was sitting in the same position as you. I was a fresh graduate from Evergreen, ready to start my next journey down at Adams State University. I thought I had it all planned out. I'd go to college and get a degree in being a doctor, marry my high school sweetheart, and be an Olympic track and field athlete. You know, the usual normal stuff that every high schooler goes through. But as you can see today, absolutely none of that came true. Probably because I honestly thought that when you finished your undergraduate, you got a degree that said you're a doctor. I thought that's all you had to do. Silly me. I thought I had it all planned out in that moment, but Sorry, let me go back. I thought I had it all planned out, but the moment I left home and started my next chapter in life, I realized how quickly life can change. After 1 year off at college, I failed my first semester of biology, I broke up with my high school sweetheart, and quit running track and field, all within that 1 year. It was after that year that I realized that I really didn't know where I was going in life, and that was terrifying for me. I thought I was destined to be a college dropout, never amounting to much, working some job just to get by and pay the bills. As I made my way home, I was bracing myself for a heavy dose of shame from Graham Geisen. But when I did get home, she did just the opposite. She told me that it was okay to fail. It was okay to not where you were going in life. That's what I needed most. I needed someone to say that it is okay to fail or make mistakes or not have things go according to plan. They rarely do when it comes to life. What matters most when you fail is that you learn from those mistakes and confidently try again. The simple thing that I did is to say yes more than I say no. Too many times did I find myself saying no because I was afraid of some silly outcome that was never going to happen. I was afraid of failure, afraid of not being perfect, and afraid of putting myself out in the world. I spent that freshman year isolated on an iceberg. I drifted by places, but I really didn't do anything as life floated by. When I finally let go of my fears and said yes, I found the best version of myself. My big first yes was to a study group to get the help I needed to successfully graduate with my degree in cellular molecular biology. I finally realized that it's not a doctor that you get a degree in. Another big yes was to living with some random guy from high school that I barely knew. Little did I know that that guy would go on to become like a brother to me, the best man at my wedding, and get me my first track and field coaching job at the local high school down in Alamosa. And as all of you know who've run track and field, I would die for track and field. That is my passion. One of the last big yeses I think of during those years off at college is when I said yes to going out on October 30th to celebrate Halloween with my best friends in the greatest costume ever, a very small road cyclist outfit. If you don't know what that is, Google search it. It's quite the suit. As all of you can imagine, the bar was completely empty. Most people would have bailed, but we said yes and powered on. As the night passed on, eventually a small group of people would show up, and my greatest fear would soon be conquered. I talked to a beautiful girl. Her name would be Connor, and when she asked me for my number, I would eagerly say yes. Now, almost 8 years later, she would be called my wife. As you go out on life's next big journey, know that you are going to fail sometimes, and that is okay. We may think we have everything planned, but you know, a virus may just come from a lab or a wet market and then spread and cause a global pandemic and lead to something called remote learning and cancel all sports and force us all to be inside for months. You know, the usual things that happen every year. As the cliche goes, life happens. As your life happens, I hope you go out and say yes to things that would normally scare you. I hope you go out and do dumb things and be smart about it. It is from those moments in life that we grow the most. And the last thing I'd love to do with you guys is, if you've had me in class before, you know I like to take the time to show value for each of you, get to know all of you, spend a little time learning something about each and every one of you. I thought it would be fitting that I would finish this address with one last get to know you. Question one, what will you say yes to over the next 11 years of your life? Question two, what fears will you overcome? And question three, what is the last thing that Mr. Geisen wants you to know? That I love you all so, so much. Congratulations again, class of 2020. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Geisen. Parents, guardians, friends, and honored guests, it is my privilege to certify on behalf of the faculty and administration of Dakota Ridge High School that these members of the class of 2020 seated before you have met the requirements for graduation as set forth by Jefferson County Public Schools. I would like to express my personal congratulations and best wishes to all of you, the graduates of Dakota Ridge High School. As you prepare to leave us and to accept new challenges and responsibilities, I hope you continue the pursuit of excellence you have begun here throughout the rest of your life. Therefore, I present the graduating class of Dakota Ridge High School and recommend that they be awarded their diplomas. It is my pleasure to introduce you to Jefferson County Public Schools Board of Education Second Vice President, Mr. Ron Mitchell.
Thank you, Dr. Jelinek, and good evening, Dakota Ridge. It is indeed a privilege and an honor to be here with all of you on this special occasion. I would like to offer my congratulations to each member of the class of 2020. I would also like to thank family, friends, and the entire D. Ridge community for the support and encouragement that have allowed members of this class to arrive at this moment. Normally, when I'm making comments at a graduation, this is a juncture where I remind all of you to say thank you to your parents, to your family, to your friends who have helped you get here. And what I really don't need to do tonight is be that redundant, because your senior class officers have already shared that thought with you, and I noticed that your principal already shared that thought with you. But what I really bring this up for is to say to you, there is a climate and culture of mutual respect that exists at Dakota Ridge High School. It exists because of you, and these things are a part of it. You should be proud of the legacy that you leave behind in that area. The last 13 years have been invested in preparing you, the graduates, to become tomorrow's leaders. I would like to encourage each of our graduates to accept the responsibility to lead and to find ways to give back to your community. You can make a difference, and you are the people that I want to lead us into the future. It is customary for a person like me to share one last piece of wisdom or last piece of advice on this occasion. One of my favorite short quotations seems to be appropriate for our graduates who have navigated the many changes caused by the coronavirus. 12 years ago, I was beginning, I'll just call it a serious and lengthy cancer treatment. And a good friend of mine sent me this quote to inspire me during this time in my life. The quote said, "Life is not about learning to avoid all the storms. Rather, life is about learning to dance in the rain." Members of this class of 2020 have experienced several unavoidable storms in the last few months as they concluded their senior year. But the fact that all of you are here tonight tells me that you are learning to dance in the rain. I believe this little lesson about life will serve you well in the years that lie ahead of you, and it will make you stronger. I wish you nothing but the best as you pursue your dreams and seek your passions. Now, on behalf of the Board of Education of Jeffco Public Schools, and based upon the recommendation of the staff and administration of Dakota Ridge High School, I accept as graduates the Dakota Ridge Class of 2020 and recommend that they be ceremoniously awarded their diplomas. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mitchell. I would like to now ask our faculty heralds, Mr. Jason Casanova and Mr. Nick Cummings, to take their places at the microphones for the presentation of diplomas. Please note that the graduates picked up their diplomas in May. Due to social distancing and health and safety protocols, graduates will not do the traditional handshake. Instead, graduates have been asked to bring their own diploma cover they received in May to hold for their picture on stage. Once the student has posed for their stage picture, they will walk off the stage back to their seat. Students, you may remove your mask for the picture, but you must replace the mask when you are done. We have some graduates who are not able to attend the ceremony today. As these graduates also put in the time and energy to meet the graduation requirements, our heralds will be recognizing them by reading their names first before we begin with those present today.
Aaron Michael Anderson, Mary Elizabeth Baca, Riley Susan Barnes, Lucas Mile Bornheft, Caitlin Jean Brace, Eric Anthony Daly Brindisi, Jacob Peter Bualdi, Angela Marie Burdick, Isabel Katerina Castianeta, Mackenzie Jocelyn Collins, Kaya Aloha Conover, Nicholas Ryan Cox, Brandon Hung Deng, Emily Marie Doolittle, Allison Leah Falco, Aaron Mitchell Fesch, Jacob Elias Fosdick, Samantha Kate Funk, Soren Eric Thor Gilbertson, Brennan James Grevy, Kenneth James Groen Jr., Marissa Lissette Hart, Matthew Jacob Heitman, Austin Matthew Hofflin, Brecken Colby Holmberg, Maxon Allen Horton, Katie Irene Ivy, Nolan Matthew James, Jameson Patrick Kennedy, Minjae Kim, Tia Christine Kratz, King Trung Lai, Samantha Joyce Levy, Gabrielle Masquili,
Dianaba Fanta Mendy, Morgan Lene Miner, Ethan Michael Mooney, Zachary James Morse, Jessica Elise Newman, Aaron Christopher Abialero, Wyatt David Oglesby, Jeremy Allen Odenettle, Tanner Michael Patino, Cameron James Pendle, Portia Bryn Perry, Aiden Edward Peterson, Braden James Rhodes, Russell Guy Rogers, Darina Rodriguez Macias, James Danielle Rowe, Kayla Elizabeth Rachinsky, Hannah E. N. Schultz, Nicholas Philip Sheely, Colin Liam Shoopman, Ness Lynn Skaggs, Caleb Bradford Smith, Marguerite Joy Smith, Zachary Michael Smith, Jacob Colby Speckman, Shane Joannis Tiemann, Dominic Alejandro Urquillo, Skyler Ryan Veer, Jenna Lynn Vigil, Savannah Marie Wells, Austin James Wood, Christian Ross Woodmansey, Jifu Zong.
Brianna Lynn Bender, Ryan Ty Bowie, Joseph Michael Carlson, Philip Robert Casey, Marco Edmundo Cordero, McKenna Margaret Dickey, Taylor K. LeGault, Nolan Kirk Miller, Madeline Nightingale Lujan, Alyssa Grace Sheehan,
Jonathan Thomas Abeda. Audrey Kathleen Adams. L. Victoria Adelaide. Luke Michael Aiden. Madison Ann Affa. Nadia Christine Afshar. Kaylee Amber Akiyama. Trevor Adam Akiyama. Quincy Ty Alexander. Jonah Zachary Allensworth. Carter Martin Andrews. Quincy Joanne Antoner. Troy Zinedine Asensio Underdown. Megan Grace Atterbury. And Kuhn Beck. Nicholas Duran Ballard. Lane Elise Ballow. Haven Serenity Barnes Stegmeyer. Allison Michelle Barrett. Jaylee Marie Benedict. Nathan Scott Benyon. Parker Mason Blatt. Ryan Parker Bloodworth.
Nolan William Bobby. Madeline Olivia Bond. Samantha Grace Bonniewell. Emma Nicole Bozier. Cecily Lynn Bowman. Noah Kyle Bratter. Luke Charles Brandt. Annika Faith Brandstrom. Kylie Marie Brewer. Catherine Lynn Bukar. Devin Blake Buchanan. Luke Alexander Bertgren.
Good job, bud.
Olivia Rain Bussey. Aaron Jacob Sage Byrne. John Francis Cahill IV. Kyle Ray Cannon. Caitlin Joe Caperton. Nico D. Capolungo. Maya Rose Castellanos. Stephen Connor Chrisman. Zoe Marie Christensen. Patrick James Sillison. Grayson Douglas Cobb.
Macy Keziah Cole. Fernanda Contreras Rios. Sarah Jacqueline Cooper. Vincent Marco Corridori. Hunter Thomas Costner. Emma Catherine Cohen. Rigel Egan Ian Cox. Scientessa Shay Cron. John Cosmo Zarnecki. Aspen Jean Daggett. Trey John D'Amico. Trey Ryan Dalton. Sage Elise Desperlay. Savannah Nicole De La Cruz. Derek Martin DeLaurier. Jacob David Diaz. Gabriella Zoe Dimmitt. Joshua Thomas Ebeling. Katie Alexandra Eckel. Nevaeh Cheyenne Espinoza. Gabriella Renee Feller.
Colin Michael Fitzgerald. Ryan Patrick Flanagan. Connor Michael Florence.
Good job, Ryan.
Alec Joseph Fries. Caden Scott Frederick. Logan Adam Gaeski.
Good job, buddy.
Caitlin Renee Gassaway.
Good job, buddy.
Lauren Grace Jendel. Lauren Kate Giebler. Ethan Alexander Good. Jagger Renal Gottschalk. Ethan John Goff. John Cody Green. Braden Walker Greer. Nathaniel Desmond Griego. Ryan Suzanne Griffin. Aaron Todd Gutierrez. Cole Torrey Hancock. Haley Lauren Harbeck. Elias Michael Harding. Peyton Lynn Harkey. Elizabeth Morgan Hawkins.
Ashley Rose Hyland. James Arthur Hess. Jordan Eugene Hicken. Megan Joy Hildebrandt. Aaron Doi Chong Wong. Stephen John Holler. Andrew Hamilton Holtz. Elsa Zoe Hipsch. Colby Keenan Hunter. Dat Man Huynh. Daniel Benjamin Ives. Cheyenne Lynn Jacks. Daphne Grace Jacobs. Austin James Jenkinson. Dakota Wellington Jesse. Anushka Marie Johnson. Emma Grace Johnson. Conrad McCray Johnson. Jackson Kiyoshi Joko. Cole Abram Jones. Ryan David Jurgemeyer. Kelly Marie Kennedy. Emily Marie Ketchum.
Olivia May Juan Kirkpatrick. Rylan William Kissel. Kylea Ruth Klaus. Maya Correa. Sarah Elizabeth Laird. Brandon Tyler Lamb. Sagan Anthony Lang. Faith Elizabeth Lawson. Hunter Robinson Ledbetter. Leighton Wesley Leeper. Nathaniel James Lemieux. Bryn Mary Dawn Lemons. Nicholas Wayne Lawallen. Devin Cletus Raymond Lindgren. Shayla Isabel Maria Lopez. Aaron Miles Lowry. Angeline Leila Luovano. Zoe Michelle Macklin. Aubrey Ann Manti.
Yeah, Aubrey.
Leah Lynette Marcus Gonzalez. Gibson Tommy Mark. Brady Alexander Marcus. Maximus Donald Marquez.
Lily Jane Mars. Brady Scott Martin. Shay McKenna Martin. Jessica Brooke Martinez. Alexis Cameron May. Bailey Ray Maines. Kayla Marie McLean. Derek James McHugh. Michael Cage McQueen. Isaac Jacob McWilliams. Lorena Lee Mendez. Ross Jeremy Mikowski. Moses Josiah Montoya. Clark Douglas Marar. Benjamin Andrew Morin. Ashley Christina Morris. Haley Rose Morris. Michaela Jean Mossbrucker. Alexander Parker Muhlenberg. George William Najera. Caden Riley Jameson Nault. Angelina Maury Navarro.
Isaac Anthony Neffs. Peyton Charles Nemers. Annika Lee Newman. William Patrick Newsom. Natalie Nguyen. Alexa Mariana Nicosia. Alexander John Norby. Emmeline May Norton.
I can't see.
Blake Paul Olson. Ryan Wallace Osborne.
Good job, Blake.
Caitlin Ann Overby. Julia Elena Papianacci. Nicholas Ryan Parrish. William Malibata Patasi. Nathan Thomas Pystrup. Kylie Marie Perez. Morgan Katerina Pericone. Maximus Daniel Phipps. Connor Eric Olson. Benjamin Michael Pigott. Emmy Brianne Pignatore. Nicholas Charles Porter. Riley Michael Puckett.
Zachary Christian Radigan. Javier Raimundo Riza Valvaldo. Connor Allen Rhodes. Jordan Day Reinard. Nicholas Christopher Richard. Alyssa Marie Robles. Heather Page Robles. Adam Rodolfo Rodriguez. Olivia Nicole Rodriguez.
Nice job, buddy.
Spencer John Rolke.
Nice job, buddy.
Kevin Alexander Roman Pizarro.
No.
Chloe Marie Romero. Colby Kenneth Michael Rose. Brianna Lynn Romero. Cade Zachary Ryan. Ezra Garcia Sagan. Isaiah Joe Salas Sotelo. Madeline Ray Sanchez. Brian Valentin Sandoval. Kylie Danette Santoro. Mason Coleman Sauter. Emily Marie Schmidt. Samantha Brenda Schmidt.
Lisa Marie Sabrell. Matthias Rose Simmons. Tyson John Craig Skanderberg. Cade Donovan Smith. Coral Ruth Smith. Savannah Gwen Stanley. Rachel Morgan Steinman. Nathaniel Dean Stewart. Thomas Joseph Stillwell.
Good job, buddy.
William Edgar Stoll.
Good job, bud.
Tristan Matthew Stone. Catherine Grace Stoppelkamp. Jillian Ann Stewart. Joseph David Sullivan. Emma Elaine Tallarico. Isaac John Tanner. Zachary Jean Testa. Joseph Anthony Thompson. Chloe Rose Thurston. Kai Joseph Tierheimer. Shannon Marie Tracy. Jordan Elise Trigg. Alyssa Lynn Trujillo.
Shanae Christina Trujillo Padilla. Riley Jordan Tyrell. Serena Danielle Vigil. Catlin Lee Wong. Anthony Francis Wagner. Catherine Paula Wardlow. Cade William Weber. Jacob Stephen Wells. Caden James Robinson.
Dana Shay Wilhelm.
Like I wouldn't be giving anybody my.
Carissa Layahi Wilkerson. Caitlin Nicole Wilson. Nathaniel Carver Wilson.
I miss you, girl.
Ashton Matthew Winey. Jamal Salim Yatribi.
Mr. Arrows.
Preston David Young. Michael Toma Youssef. Jordan Dean Ziegler. Grace Anna Block Zinzer.
All right, let's give them one more round of applause, please.
What's that cheer? Yeah, Mike.
Want to also specially thank all of our health workers and the stadium crew, and under John McDonald, Jeffco Security. Thank you very much for all your help tonight. I do have a couple of logistic directions for you as we near the end of graduation. Please remember, at the conclusion of the ceremony, everyone must exit the stadium. We are not allowed to congregate in the seating areas or on the field. Following the final thoughts from our student body, President and Vice President Taylor and Joe, the students on the stage will leave the stage and escort the graduates row by row out of the stadium. Graduates, we'll have you please wait for your row monitor to tell you when to go. Please remember to keep your masks on until you get to your vehicles. If you exit that way to the west stands, you're going to go around and out the way that you came in. If you exit this way on the east side, you're actually going to go down the runner, and at E17, which is the last row, you're going to take a U-turn and come back out and go this way. Okay? On behalf of the school administration and staff of Dakota Ridge High School, I want to wish you all the best of luck. We love you, and we wish you the happiness, all the happiness and good fortune in the world. Within our mission statement, School Icons, to live, love, learn, and leave a legacy, I have found the most rewarding experience with students leaving positive school legacies. Among my most favorite memories are the innovative chants and cheers with which our Dakota Ridge students scream in order to support their fellow Dakota Ridge students. It never ceases to send a chill up my spine, and I haven't heard it in quite a while, whenever I hear the grammatically incorrect but motivational chant, "Who we be," followed immediately by "D Ridge, D Ridge." One last time before I turn the mic over, I would like to hear this chant at the top of your voices. Who we be?
D Ridge, D
Ridge. Who we be?
D Ridge, D Ridge.
Who we be?
Eagles.
Our student body president and vice president, Taylor LeGault and Joe Carlson.
Good evening, and thank you all for attending our graduation ceremony. Although this is not exactly the graduation or finish that we hoped for, I'm glad we are able to be here and celebrate today. We would like to thank our amazing staff for helping us get to this stage, as well as our parents, family members, peers, and the rest of the Dakota Ridge community. Most importantly, we would like to recognize Dr. J for all of his hard work during these last 4 years.
We have faced many obstacles throughout the year, and without our teachers and administration, we would not be where we are today. Thank you, Ms. Lucas, for not only planning one graduation ceremony, but two. Our administration has helped us in so many ways during our time at Dakota Ridge, especially towards the end of the academic year. Memories from our time at Dakota will stay with us forever, like when Mr. Heckle attempted to chase down the streaker right here on this field. We cannot forget Kimmy K's announcements for dress code and absolutely no hats or hoods at school. The best one yet was at homecoming when Miss Lucas stood on the stage and demanded for our mosh pit to end. The mosh pit continued right after, and she became famous on Barstool. We love you, Miss Lucas.
High school is full of memories that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives. We each have a unique story about our experience as a Dakota Ridge Eagle. Fortunately, my story begins 18 years ago when I was born into the Dakota Ridge family. I spent the majority of my childhood at Dakota, either on the baseball field or in the gym. I cannot wait for the day to finally become a high school student. My 4 years here went by faster than I ever expected. Senior year came along and I was provided with the opportunity to lead my school. I had many goals and expectations, and without the rest of the senior class, none of those would have happened. We, as an entire class, changed our school environment, such as our rowdy student sections, our pep rallies, school spirit, Free Hug Friday, and the overall community of our school. This year was unlike any other. Even though the last 2 months were cut short by the pandemic, the months preceding COVID-19 were tremendous. We had fireworks at football games, a wedding in Main Hall, and mosh pits at school dances. We got through so much, but most importantly, we got through so much together. I'm happy to say that my story ended with the best group of people at the best school.
High school for me went by way faster than I ever could have expected. As a freshman, I thought this day would never come, but it did, and I learned lots along the way. I learned the fastest way to get to Chick-fil-A during lunch. I learned the exact time I needed to leave my house in order to get to school right on time or 2 minutes late. I learned that it is possible to run to Spencer Rolke's house to change into a new pair of pants during lunch and still make it to class on time. But that story is for another day. All kidding aside, Dakota Ridge has taught me many valuable lessons, that I will be able to reflect on for the rest of my life. I could not have asked for a better school or a better class to graduate with. Like Taylor said, we as a class have achieved amazing things for Dakota Ridge. I am very proud to say I was a part of the 2020 class at Dakota Ridge High School. And although none of us thought we would ever want to go back to school, COVID-19 made us realize how much we will really miss high school. Personally, I am very excited to be able to tell my children about graduating online in the year 2020.
As a class, we have one similar story. I can proudly say that we, the class of 2020, have lived, loved, learned, and left our legacy. We started as one of the most difficult freshman classes and finished as the strongest senior class. Together, we created an environment at our school that is full of school spirit, positivity, and leadership.
Our story as Dakota Ridge Eagles may end here, but the next chapter of our lives is just beginning. We challenge you to continue your legacy wherever you may go. One of the biggest lessons we can take away from this year is to never take anything for granted. Don't look backwards at what happened, look forward to what is ahead.
After watching what our class is capable of accomplishing, I have no doubt that we will make an amazing impact on the world. We wish you all the best, and of course, remember,
all Eagles, all family.
Okay, it is now time for everyone to please stand and move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Yeah. You are my fire, the one desire.